Hello, I'm Jimmy, and I'm hosting this month's edition of Wolf Tracks. Our first story today is about the polar bear jump.
Wait a minute,
polar bears can't jump?
I beg to differ!
Looks like I need to learn more about polar bears, and a lot more about the polar bear jump. Here's Joe Yorba for more.
That is me, having the opportunity to do what some people call over the top, but I call it the cold body refreshment of the polar bear plunge. The polar bear plunge takes place once a year on New Year's Day at the Olalla Lagoon right next to Al's store. This year is the 24th annual polar bear plunge, claimed to be the state's largest polar bear plunge with more than 1,000 people turning out for the event.
This is my first year.
This is my first time.
A replica of the Civil War cannon blasted its booming noise off at noon, signaling the official plunge into the frostbiting bay. Then when they come from the bay with invisible icicles hanging from each and either way, they rush on next to the bonfire to melt away like whipped cream and hot chocolate.
Cold as the water.
Really cold.
Cold, man. Cold.
After they are all warmed up, they go over to the stand and get a certificate to have proof that they had done the polar bear plunge.
Yikes! They must be brave to do that. I could never do that. Not after what happened to me those many years ago. Ugh. That happened way back when I used to be a professional snowboarder. And speaking of snowboarding, here's Jordan Perry with all the information you'll ever need to know about snowboarding.
Most all of us know what the extreme sport of snowboarding is. If you've ever done it before, you know that it takes years of practice to get good at the sport. So come with me while I learn about snowboarding, our local riders, and what they do.
My name is Drew Sadler. I've been snowboarding probably for off and on about 6 years now.
My name is Brett Perry, and I've been boarding for 8 years now.
Daniel Nato, six seasons.
These boarders may have been riding for years, but they started out just like any other rider, at the bottom of a rail, you could say. But there isn't snow all year round, so how do these rough riders practice and keep in their tip-top shape while they can't hit the slopes?
Basically every day, every moment we can, when we're bored, we go out longboarding.
Freeboarding is a good one, like an alternative to snowboarding.
I do a lot of board sports like wakeboard, skateboard, skimboard, longboard. I can think they help with coordination and balance.
About every day in my life, every day since I've really been, you know, started snowboarding, I've been watching snowboard movies.
Yeah, we gotta find a trick to do it on.
You know, for any sport, watching a professional do their job, you know, perfecting things, it always helps.
Bucket riding, it sounds crazy, but can pretty much strap in, put your board on, and kind of spin across the bucket. Helps your balance.
I like to get a feel for my board before I'm on the snow. I'll put my stuff on, my boots and my board, and then I'll just kind of jump around a little bit, get the feel for the flex of the board.
Another way the riders pass the time in the off season is buying new gear.
Yeah, actually, well, every year in Gig Harbor, at the Gig Harbor High School, they call it a ski swap. And I'm hoping to get a new snowboard there. I'm hoping.
Now, this isn't exactly a conservative or safe sport to experience, so it has to be a point in time where someone either stops or decides this is a life decision. Something that they see or a memory they pull out where they say, wow, I need to do this for the rest of my life.
Probably the biggest moment would be up at Baker. I saw just another guy on the slopes pushing it and throwing stuff that I've never seen like in person before. And that just really inspired me to go out there and push it as hard as I could. And
it's not really a single moment. It was more like every single moment.
I remember I was on the hill and I was by myself and it was really quiet. There was no one else on the hill. And I just remembered thinking, wow, I'm having the best time of my life right now.
So while you're out there wanting to start snowboarding, take the advice from these boarders and practice, even when the snow isn't falling.
I used to be able to do some pretty cool moves myself. I wonder if I still got it. Hey Jimmy, have you seen my cat opener? I'm trying to open a can of cat cream corn, but I can't find my cat opener.
Okay, see you later, Jimmy.
Well, anyway, I guess that leads us to our next story with Grant McMeekin about Winter Olympics.
For thousands of years, there have been winter competitions, but there is only one that brings all the best to one place to compete to be the very best. The Winter Olympics are held every 4 years in different locations. According to legend, the ancient Olympic Games were founded by Heracles, a son of Zeus. Now let's fast forward 1,000 years to Whistler, British Columbia, where the Winter Olympics will be held in 2010.
In 1920, okay, and a woman called Myrtle Phillips and her husband came from Vermont. And they took a train to Squamish, which is about 45 minutes south of here. And then they came up here by horseback. And then a few years later, some men came up here and decided that they would build a lift so that they could have the Olympics in 1968.
Today, there are many new and exciting activities in Whistler during the winter, like skiing or snowboarding. There are also many restaurants, shops, and nightclubs. Strong winds and temperatures below minus 50 degrees. That's what the athletes have to face in the upcoming Olympics. I went out on the street and asked people what they thought of it.
I have a condo here. I'm a property owner, and I think it's going to help increase the values. I think it's going to bring a lot of notoriety to this area.
I think it'll be great for Whistler, the Squamish Valley, and Vancouver.
I love the Olympics, and it'll bring a lot of people to the area.
It's going to be interesting, exciting. It's going to bring a lot of business into the Canada, Vancouver, Seattle area. So good for the business.
There are currently 6 sports: skiing, skating, bobsled, skeleton, and the Paralympic Games. So when 2010 rolls around, be sure to take the short drive north, past the border, over the bridge, and across the mountains to Whistler, Canada for the Olympic Games.
Yeah. Looks like I could never compete with that. Looks like snowboarding is just another failed career of mine, like when I was a lumberjack. Or even a few days I spent as a blender tester. This next story is about the Career Center. Maybe that could help me. Here's Josh to tell us more about the Career Center.
A higher education is the goal of many high school students today. And here at South Kitsap, we have a place where students can go and learn about thousands of colleges around the world. It's called the Career Center. The Career Center at South Kitsap High School is available to assist the students to be successful in setting goals, examining career opportunities, and thinking and planning ahead academically. The Career Center is open 6:30 a.m. to 3 p.m. every day. Dee Adams is a career counselor, and I got to talk to her for more information.
We've just finished giving an online interest inventory to all of our sophomores, and this is a piece of information that will go into student portfolios. So through our science classes, we administered the interest inventory to the sophomores in preparation for their registration that will be happening within the next month.
I go to the Career Center to talk about my future because I want to go to college, and they taught me how to fill out the paperwork and get me all signed up for to talk to the colleges about what I want to take in my future. I also go down there for the job board to find out what job opportunities they have down there that I could take.
Well, I needed a job, and I heard that the Career Center had a bunch of job flyers, so I went down there and signed my name up on a bunch of job flyers.
Seniors, whatever your plan, if you have not begun the process, come to the Career Center and we'll help you kind of sort things out. First thing we'll give you is that FAFSA form to get you started.
Many high school students have never even been in the Career Center, even seniors. And they've been here for 3 years. You need to remember that the choices that you make right now affect your entire life, and this place is supposed to be used for your benefit. It's not too late, though. Come in today and check it out to get a jump start on your career opportunities.
It sure would be nice to get a new job. I could be making a lot more money than I am now. If only.
From the king of rock, there is none higher. Fire MCs should call me sire. To rule my kingdom, you must choose fire. I won't stop rocking until I retire. Now we rock the party and come correct. All cuts are on time.
I'd be living the good life, but where could I stow all my money? This next story is about the credit union. Perhaps I could keep it there.
Recently, South Kitsap High School was chosen by the Kitsap Federal Credit Union to have a bank in their school. Some might wonder, why would you choose to put a bank inside a school?
So we are proud to bring the vocational education and the marketing students that you meet later will be hands-on in this branch, doing what all of our financial representatives and tellers do throughout our community, serving the public.
It would be easier for me to like deposit money and stuff because a lot of times like I never deposit my checks and stuff. So if I had a bank in the school, I'd be able to cash my checks and everything way quicker instead of procrastinating and not getting my money in the end.
The credit union kicked off their grand opening with an official ribbon cutting. Many people came to show their support. On top of the ribbon cutting, the credit union also held a prize giveaway during all four lunches in the Commons, with the main attraction being the cash cube. A student from each lunch had a chance to win up to $400 in the cash cube.
I want a $5 gift certificate to Wendy's.
All my friends just came up to me and they're like, oh my god, Aaron, you won, go up there. And I was like, really? And I won this free board game.
Even if you didn't win anything, the credit union also gave away cookies from Costco, credit union tri-lighters, and mini footballs. At fourth lunch, our own principal, Mr. Holston, got a chance to go into the cash cube. He won $200 going towards our school. The credit union also graciously decided to give the rest of the money in the cash cube to the school. This event turned out to be a total success.
Well, mostly what I've learned has been how to work in a credit union and or a bank. It would kind of transfer to any other like accounting service or anything like that. It really helps to work with money and everything.
So if you ever need money at our school for any reason, go to our school bank at any lunchtime.
Alright, Hunter, move the left hand a bit. No. The right hand to the left, not the left hand to the left. Alright, that was good-ish, I guess.
I'm sick of this animation, I'm sick of that giant cone, and I am so sick of you. I have such an easy idea that we'll get rid of this. So here's Robert Vosbring with Sign Choir.
Can you hear voices? No. They must be pretty good then. For many years on December 13th, the South Kitsap Sign Choir has been silently contributing to South Kitsap's pride with a yearly holiday concert. This gives the hearing impaired an opportunity to see and feel the holiday spirit with some songs that are fun.
What's this? There's nothing everywhere. What's this? There's white things in the air. What's this? I can't believe my...
And some that touch the heart.
Why can't I find you?
show like this presents a large responsibility, though, so practice is crucial.
We're actually going to do pretty well. It's been kind of hectic the last couple weeks, but I think we're ready.
As you can see, they're not worried. During their performance, these silent singers, under the instruction of Mrs. Karen Johnson, become beacons of joy with group performances, duets, and a very special performance by the twins. It was such a heartfelt performance, it's no surprise they signed for a full house. The show ended to an exceptional ovation, and the crowd loved it.
You know, it was great. I loved it. It was amazing.
It's a bunch of fun. And people should get into it more often.
Every Christmas season, these high school students give the best present of all, the joy of music and the Christmas spirit, to the hearing impaired, children, and adults alike.
Well, this Wolf Tracks has been a long, painstaking journey, but so far, well worth it. And before we go on to the next story, let's reflect. First, we saw brave souls crash into icy waters. Then we saw...
Hunter, you're kind of rambling, so let's try to keep it going along. Here, let the master do his work. This next story is about YouTube by Eric Lee, so hope you guys enjoy that.
What are you doing behind the curtains, Casey?
Shh! The next story awaits you.
It would be a valid argument to say that you can do just about anything on the internet. But here's one thing I bet you've been looking forward to for quite some time. TV Online. That's right, it's here. On the internet, you can now watch some of your favorite show and movie clips, or even some personal shorts by people just like you and me. And it's all on a website called YouTube.com. Founded in 2005, the site has become an internet phenomenon. Within the short 11 months after its creation, YouTube became one of the most popular places on the internet. YouTube offers mainstream shows from the current season.
So, from time to time, I send Dwight faxes.
From TV's earliest days, and homemade movies from around the world. And the best part is, you get to watch them whenever you want. You just type in the video you're looking for, and you're watching some of your favorite videos.
It's pretty fascinating. It's nice being able to go to a site and just be able to download some random videos. Comedy sketches, things like that, is usually what I'll check out if I do go to that website, so it's pretty interesting.
Despite the site's huge success, there has been some controversy, as users often post copyrighted material. And although YouTube is filled with talent from all corners of the earth, there are still a lot of strange videos out there.
Fight me now!
And where have I been?
Where have you been? Where have you been?
Well, I've got three words for you.
With your girlfriend?
World of Warcraft.
Oh, that was my second guess.
Yeah.
Each person visits YouTube for different reasons. Some people simply like to just explore the thousands of videos.
I watch pretty much random clips of everything. Probably not a man. If there's anything bad on YouTube, I've probably found it.
Others, on the other hand, like to share and view home movies.
I haven't had a lot of experience with YouTube. We've looked up some videos that were pretty funny, and some friends of mine had some home videos that we enjoyed.
Continuing its quest for video perfection, YouTube is constantly updating itself, and has a variety of features to help you in your search for quality video. The first feature, and probably most common amongst websites, is the search bar, where you can type in the title of the video that you are searching for. The second is the categories for tab, where videos are divvied into various categories. The third feature is the channels tab, where specific videos are broadcasted, much like the channels on TV. As YouTube continues to progress, users can only guess as to what they'll think of next. With the opportunity to view our favorite videos at the click of a button, one wonders how many undiscovered Spielbergs or Lucases that are just waiting to break out will make their rise to prominence. And who knows, maybe YouTube is your ticket to fame.
Oh, hello. I was just playing doctor. Well, sadly, like Jimmy's life, the show has come to an end. And as you can see, we no longer need him anymore. So we're doing experiments to benefit Claykind. So, let us get back to work. Pointy thingy. What are you doing? Get out of here.